You probably know that sample counts are very, very accurate, but do you know that something weird happened to three SMCs in GE2020? Watch on to know why it's so accurate. What happened to those SMCs in 2020? So, sample counts are so accurate that some of us go back to sleep after all the sample counts are out. But you might want to watch this to the end if you're someone like that. For a start, what are sample counts? You probably know by now that sample counts were being published since GE2015. But here's the thing. Actually, sample counts were being counted even before GE2015. You see, before GE2015, sample counts were being counted, but they were not published to the public. Because initially, the sample counts are not to give you an idea of what the results are. It's to kind of, you know, match what the final results are. Now, let's say that after counting 100 votes, Cat's Action Party has 68% of the votes. If, in the final result, Cat's Action Party only has 19% of the votes, we will know that something is wrong. Therefore, it's to check against the final results. However, as the internet becomes more mainstream, people started to spread information about the so-called early results, whether they are correct or not. That is why, from GE2015, the authorities released sample count results to the public, mainly to prevent speculation and misinformation from unofficial sources while counting is underway. After all, if someone is going to leak the sample count results, whether it's a real result or not, we might as well just reveal the real sample count's result lah. But how is sample count counted leh? Actually, it's very, very easy. The place we vote is called a polling station. Each SMC or GRC has a few polling stations. The bigger your SMC or GRC is, the more you will have lah. So, a counting assistant will take 100 block papers from each polling station and count them. They will be added up and the weightage will be based on the number of voters cast in each polling station. As usual, all counting will be done in front of the candidates and counting agents for transparency's sake. Simply put, it's like taking a small percentage of the block paper lah. But why is it so accurate? For laymen like us, we just know it's accurate lah. But ask any statistician and they can give you a formula to show you why it's accurate. Then, according to the website of a research scientist, the formula to calculate the margin of error is this. I know you are going to ask me what that is, so here's the answer. I don't know lah, I'm just a cat on the internet and not a research scientist. I have left the link of his work on the description of his website, but what you need to know is this. It's not something random. It's statistic, and if you're as educated as me, you'll know that almost everything in the world can be calculated and predicted with statistics and maths. Eh? What cannot be predicted with statistics and maths?
Hey, I tell you what.
You see, we can think of it as TV viewership lah. Before the internet, how can companies know if a TV program is being watched by how many people? Similarly, they merely use the results of a small percentage of TV watchers, and from there, they will have a good idea of how many people watch the show. This is why in sample votes for elections, it is very accurate. 95 out of every 100 times, the results from the sample count will be very close to the final results, usually within 4% difference. So if the sample count says Party A got 54% of the votes, the actual result is likely to be somewhere between 50% and 58%. Now, this leads to the next question. It is only 95 out of 100 times. Will it be, wrong? Now, firstly, you should stay up late for results within the 4% margin of error. If the sample count is 51% of a party, it can therefore swing both ways. For example, in GE2020, the sample count for West Coast GRC is 52% for the PAP, and in Sengkang, it is 53% for WP, so they can go both ways. But it didn't swing, although there's a chance it can, since the margin of error is 4%. But will it go beyond 4%? Well, yes, because remember, it's often said that the sample count has a confidence rate of 95%, which means it will be correct 95 times out of 100 times. There's always this 5 times out of 100 times that it didn't get it within the 4% margin, and it showed in not 1, not 2, but 3 SMCs during GE2020. The sample count for Kampubaru SMC is 68% for the PAP, but the final result is 62.97%, which is a difference of 5.03%. For Pioneer SMC, the sample count is 66% for the PAP, but the final result is 61.98%, which is a difference of 4.02%. And finally, for Punggol West SMC, the sample count is 65%, but the final result is 60.97%. Which is the difference of 4.03%. Yes, we can tell that SMCs have worse sample count projections compared to GRCs, mainly because GRCs will have more sample count votes. So if you really want the advice, just ensure that you stay up late for the SMC or GRC you are interested in for the final results. Because if you realize, usually the results of the closely contested GRCs or SMCs will be revealed last. If you want to know what are the GRCs and SMCs that will have a close fight, watch this. And thank you for spending almost 5 minutes with me. I really appreciate it.